Hey, it's Doug Atkinson here at Identiverse 2018. We're here with Vittorio Bertacci, principal architect from Auth0. And interestingly enough, you just spent 17 years at Microsoft before you joined Auth0. What brought you to those guys? You know, what is it that's happening in the space right now that you found to be interesting enough to make such a move?
Thank you for having me. I knew the founders because we worked together in Microsoft precisely on this topic years ago. And in Microsoft, I was doing something very similar to what I'm doing today. Like, I was working with identity and developers. And that Microsoft is a very large place, which does many different things. And Auth0 instead has like a singular focus on identity as a service, and in particular, it has like this special relationship with developers. And that's precisely the nexus of my interests. So I decided that after some time, it was interesting to have a change and to move in a like more agile environment. And so here I am.
So with regard to the service for developers, talk a little bit about where Auth0 is staked a claim.
Auth0 is an identity as a service proposition, which is as an idea pretty common at this point of the industry, as in like identities on the critical path of every functionality, especially if you have to cross chasms, like get into the cloud from your on-prem and similar. And I think that there is there are areas in identity management, such as developer experience, that are underserved. And say that traditionally, identity has been an administrative motion, in which like admins provision users, provision applications, establish policies, are the guardian of like things running in the right way. But as we get to environments that are more and more heterogeneous, like as in different type of applications, different ways of consuming data, like from mobile to IoT, to long running processes on the server, to continuous integration, to the classic web applications. And as we get to a wider and wider variety of ways of deploying your resources, like you have your classic on-prem stuff, but then you target things in Azure, in AWS, you run things serverless, you put everything in a container, and then who knows where you're going to run it. So there is this aspect of dynamic processes coming together for serving a purpose and then unraveling or integrating with sources from very different owners, like SaaS apps and similar. And I'm getting almost to my point. Sorry, I blubber a lot.
It's an interesting point, which is, you know, in addition to identity moving so quickly and being having to be dealt with so critically right now, all these other things are happening simultaneously, and there does need to be consideration and orchestration around how to connect those dots that are all moving so fast.
You are absolutely right. As in, identity is the enabler. Sometimes people like to say the glue that actually enables all the things that you just described. And with the variety getting wider and wider, the role of a development it rises in importance. As in, now you find yourself more and more often having to put together a solution really fast with changing conditions, with like a wide variety of things that you need to deal with. And so having a strong developer story becomes not like a nice to have, like it might have been perceived as such some time ago, but now it becomes more and more a key component of your ability to execute. And so Auth0, which puts this special emphasis on the developer experience, on making identity usable for developers that really care more about what you just said, as in like doing all these processes and like getting to their business value. And they are not necessarily experts in the details. And having a service which gives you identity like on top substantially empowers you to take advantage of all these new opportunities without burdening you with the need of understanding the fine-grained details, which are better left to the experts.
So where are you finding the traction right now in the enterprises? Is it larger enterprises? Is it mid-market?
This is another excellent point, which is up to recently, customers tended to self-segregate in very neat categories. Like you'd have scenarios in which you have B2E, in which an enterprise is doing server consolidation and moving everything to the cloud, and then their interest is in authenticating their own employees. And then you'd have B2Bs in which you have SaaS applications which are meant to be consumed by businesses, and then the software vendors need to devise ways of signing up entire organizations, deal with different policies and similar. And then you'd have B2C scenarios in which you have applications that are meant to be consumed by external consumers, so like coming from their own username and password, or coming with social providers, Facebook, Weibo, WeChat, if you are coming from China and similar. And what's happening today is exactly on the trend that I described earlier, which is more and more you find yourself straddling these different areas in which you might have a B2E solution in which you need to be able to invite the consultant which is helping you for some project, and then you don't want to provision them in your directory. So you just want your application to be capable of dealing both with your employees and with the external. Or you might have a eminently B2B scenario in which you normally work with companies, but then you have some company that doesn't have the federation capabilities that you'd expect from a bigger business, and so you need to onboard them with something similar to B2C. So the answer is there is a long tail, and then pretty much everyone, given that everyone deals with these distributed resources, pretty much everyone needs to deal with identity today.
Well, and really the point is that everyone's different as well, right? And in the end, what they have for integration challenges is very unique. And as a result, they oftentimes need that extra help to sort it all out.
That is absolutely right. And the one thing that we do as an industry, not just of Xero, is we tend to rely whenever it's possible on open standards. Like conferences like this one are instrumental in doing like cross-pollination and understanding each other's challenges and coming out with concerted solutions, as in like in which we, if we need to advance specific aspects of some of the standard protocols and similar, we do it exactly during this kind of events. And that's normally what we have as default, as in we have for the canonical solutions, standard solutions based on open protocols and similar, so that there is also like a skill transfer. If someone is used to do a certain thing with one vendor, they have reasonable expectations that they'll be able to apply the same skill with some other vendor. Then, of course, the last mile, the thing that makes everyone else unique, the impedance mismatch that you need to somehow match once the canonical scenario hits the road and you really need to make it happen in practice is what makes the difference. Like it's the competitive advantage of choosing one solution versus the other.
It's incredible what's happening these days. Certainly this event is getting larger and larger. We're going to be keeping a track on Auth0, see where you're headed. Certainly enjoyed speaking with you today. And
thanks for having
me. Best rest of the show and best of luck with the new opportunity.
Thank you.